What's going on? We're back with another biking video, and today we're right here in Coronado Island in San Diego, California. It's a nice sunny day, and we're going to be biking the entire island. That's the challenge, and we'll hit up important landmarks such as the Hotel Coronado. So we'll see how this turns out. So our first cool sight to see, like you saw in the intro, is the Coronado Bridge, and this connects all the way to downtown San Diego. Right now, as you can see, going out of Coronado, there's a bit of traffic, so luckily we didn't have to face that coming in. We're down here right under the bridge. As you can see and hear all the different cars passing right above us. Alright, so our journey is beginning right at 3 p.m. So we'll see how long it takes us, and I'll also keep track of how many miles it ends up being. So coming up, you see Tidelands Park, and this is actually where I parked. I believe parking is free. I guess we'll find out if I get a ticket at the end, but as far as I know, it is free. Tidelands Park has a huge field to do a bunch of different activities, so if that's something that you're interested in or bringing your dog out here, definitely a good idea. So right away we get a really cool view of downtown San Diego. Off to our right, we get to see, I believe it's the convention center and just a bunch of the other big buildings. I believe Petco Park is also in the distance. Here's a bit of a better view. You got a big shipping container boat coming up, and then you've got the city down there with all of its cool skyscrapers. This little shopping center that you have to ride through, and then hopefully it takes us back onto the right next to the water. And sure enough, it shoots us out right here next to the Coronado Ferry Landing, and it seems like a bunch of people are actually getting on that ferry to go back to downtown. It's a better view. Part about this trail is that it is accessible to basically everyone. You see people on e-bikes, regular bikes, beach bikes. I'm doing mine on a mountain bike. I mean, I don't think it makes a difference, just because the trail is super flat and you see people of all different types of ages, which is really cool and neat to see. So right next to the trail you get these little beach areas for people to be able to sit down and just enjoy that really cool skyline. Here's a little bit of a better view of that. Kind of going with the flow here. The bike path appears to end next to the water, but usually maybe it wraps around here and continues. We're just kind of, and sure and behold, it was just a nice right turn at that little end of that little resort, and you're back on the main road. I was able to find this nice little park here. It's called Harbor View Park. If you're trying to just get away from the crowds, if you're after that little quick detour, we're back on the bike path, and it seems like it goes on for a while. It appears like we're approaching the naval base, which I'm sure we won't be able to get in. There's a little sign here that says 1.3 miles to the beaches, and then the US Navy to the front, 1.7 to Hotel Coronado, so we have a decision to make. Okay, so we took a right, or I should say a left at that last point after we tried to get in, and now we are back on the main road. So we're passing the hotel, or I should say that we're passing the Coronado Naval Air Station right there. Well, that whole little section there was kind of uneventful. I mean, if you're into just looking at nice houses, that's a good little stretch for you, but we're gonna do as much of the island as possible and that's open to the just regular public. Take a quick little detour to the right because it appears like we might be able to see the beach from this side over here. Another one of the military entrances, but if we go off to the left here, what do we see? The beach! You can see a really cool view of the beach. Kind of looks a little bit dead over here, which is expected. I mean, it's a Thursday afternoon, so not really much happening. Alright, we took a right to get out of that little space of beach, and we're back on it. on the trail to try to get to Hotel Coronado. I recommend, if you're gonna come down here to do anything in Coronado, do it during a weekday, preferably Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, just because Friday, Saturday, Sunday down here is always kind of a little bit congested, just because this is one of the most popular places in San Diego. There's a little section off to the right, and I'm gonna try to ride on this little sand area here, because why not? Just to get a little bit of change of scenery. Very difficult to ride on the sand, as I've learned. Sometimes the sand throws you off in weird ways, but luckily it's flat enough. Here's a cool view of the bike right in front of this ocean portion. That's our first little glimpse of the beach, so let's get back on this main road here. Alright, we're approaching this Hotel Coronado section, and this is probably going to be the most popular area over here. Alright, so we're right here in front of Hotel Coronado, one of the most iconic places here in San Diego, and it's currently... This is such a nice place to walk, bike, run, even just, you know, take in that nice view, even if you're just driving here and not planning on doing anything. Okay, so there's a little section over there that continues, but that's only for pedestrians, so we're not gonna break the rule there, and we're just gonna go and see if we do the Bayshore Drive. Is that whole trip, maybe around 5 miles, has taken us less than even a mile, or an hour, I should say. Okay, so we're probably gonna do a little bit of the section of the Bayshore Drive trail. So we'll make it to Silver Strand State Beach, and I think we'll turn back there. From this point on, it is 4.5 miles away. This is where an e-bike would come up clutch. Again, I see just a bunch of e-bikes zooming past it, and I decided on just turning back. We got 2 miles in to the Bayshore Trail, and I just was looking around, and it didn't seem like anything that impressive over here. All right, well, we're starting to get back into Coronado, which is nice to see, after that little detour, which led nowhere. So let's explore a little bit more. Take a quick little detour over here by apparently the Coronado Community Playhouse. I'm guessing that's some sort of a theater or something. But we get really close here, we get to see all these boats docked. And all right, we're right here in front of the Hotel Del Coronado, and we're gonna explore it a little bit. It looks like we're gonna have a really cool sunset today, and Hotel Coronado has so many different restaurants they offers, such as the pizzeria, the ice cream shop, and there's all these little food trucks over here as well. This area appears to be closed, but usually inside of the little square gathering that they usually have really cool things and just a cool little patio. During Christmas time, they also have a really big tree covered in lights. Back on the road here, and we're gonna go to that main little city center. Let's cross here. So if you come down here to the downtown of Coronado, you'll have both very fancy, exclusive little restaurants that you can check out for a nice night out. Or if you're just looking for something quick, they have Subway, Domino's, all your little traditional food chains. So there's a variety. These are all just the little stores that they have down here. And I'm cruising down this main street of stores. This is also, there's a couple places here where it's a good option to rent a bike if you don't have one, or an e-bike as well. Coronado offers a lot of different types of parks. They have this little town center sort of town square park right here. I think really close to Tideland's Park, where a car is parked. And so far, I think I've done around 12 miles, and that was with the add-on of the 4 miles of me being indecisive. So not that long if you're just doing the island. We're back where we started, Coronado Bridge here in Tidelands Park. Definitely a really cool bike ride today. It was around 12 miles. I added a couple, three more miles, so it should have just been a 9 mile bike ride. I definitely recommend it because it's an accessible bike ride for basically any skill level. There's lots of places where you can rent e-bikes and regular bikes here as well. Thank you for joining me on this adventure, and stay tuned for more to come.